one brand tutorial is going to be on Sun and Park. All the products in this video were provided by SohuGlam.com, so if you're interested in any of them, definitely check out their website. They have a lot of curated and amazing Korean beauty products. I will put the link down below of all the products that I used in this video, so if you're curious, you can find exactly where to get them. Now let's go ahead and jump into the tutorial. Good morning, everyone! So to prep my skin, I'm going to start off with this beauty water. Now this is very, very famous as it is a cleansing water and a toner all in one. It does an amazing job at exfoliating, cleaning, toning, and prepping the skin for makeup, so everything just goes on a lot more smooth. Now to give you guys a little bit of background of Son and Park, Son and Park are both Korean makeup artists that are some of the most famous makeup artists in Korea at the moment. Son Dae-sik and Park Tae-yeon are the masterminds behind the dewy, glowing skin that Korean women are really known for. So if you're into that look and you've seen it on the runways or in K-dramas or just out and about in Seoul, you know who to give the credit to. One overlying theme of their makeup line, which I really appreciate, is their philosophy of skin first. So instead of just using makeup to cover up imperfections, they actually have a lot of benefits in their makeup and skincare, which helps improve the skin in general. For my foundation, I'm going to use the Glow Ring Foundation. Now this is cool because the foundation stick is on one side and it has a little ring in there that has a moisturizing essence to it. And then on the other side, it has this very dense brush which helps blend out the foundation perfectly, effortlessly, and seamlessly. So it's just such an easy foundation to work with. The shade that I'm using is number 23 Natural. Like I just mentioned, this foundation is super easy to work with, so how I use it is I just swipe the foundation onto my skin and I just apply however much I think I need. Then I go back in with the brush on the other side and I just use it to blend in the foundation. This foundation is really excellent for that no makeup, makeup type of look, and my dry skin really likes the moisturizing properties to it. However, I don't feel like this is too oily for those of you guys who have oily skin. I feel like if you add a little bit of powder, it'll be perfect for pretty much every skin type. And I also like to build this up because it doesn't have the highest coverage, because you can see that pimple up on my forehead kind of peep out throughout the day, but nothing that a little concealer can't correct. So just to show you kind of what this looks like, on the right side I haven't blended it in and on the left side I have, and this is what it looks like all over my skin, so you can see how beautiful and natural this foundation looks. Plus this matches my skin tone almost perfectly. Now I personally like to set my foundation, and for those of you guys who have oily skin, you probably want to set your foundation if you're using this one in particular. So to do that, I'm going to use this Flawless Pore Pack. Now this is a translucent powder which helps minimize the appearance of pores, so it's really great for all skin types. Again, my dry skin really likes this. It doesn't dry out my skin or make it look cakey at all. It's just a really nice, light, and natural looking powder. So I'm just going to take the little puff that comes with it and pat the powder on areas that I tend to get oily or the foundation tends to move around on, like underneath my eyes, my chin, my forehead, on my nose. And you can see on this side, I haven't set the foundation, so you can see what it looks like, and this side I have. And of course, this is what it looks like all over my skin. Now it's time to move on to the eye makeup. So I'm going to take the All That Shimmering Kit, which is a very beautiful and neutral eyeshadow palette. I'm actually going to use the insert that comes with it as a guideline so you can kind of see the look that Son and Park intended to do with this palette specifically. And to show you what the color payoff looks like, these are swatches on the back of my hand of the palette without any primer. Now before I get to the actual eyeshadow, I'm going to use this product here, and I'll get to explaining this product in a second, but I'm going to take the shimmery side and just use this as a base for my eyelids. The first eyeshadow that I'm going to use is called Cinnamon Sand, and I'm just going to use this with a blending brush and apply this into my crease. I'm next going to take Vintage Brown and use this to define my crease a little bit more, so I'm just going to use the same brush and just lightly run over the color we just applied. Taking the darkest color in the palette, which is called Walnut Brown, I'm just going to use this on the outer corner of my eye, but you'll also see me kind of dragging it outward to make my eye look a little bit bigger. Following that, I'm going to take Gold Leaf and just apply it right underneath my eye as a highlight. Now we are going to go back to that product that I used to base my eyelids. This is the Plumping and Shaping Pencil Duo. So on one side it has the creamy, shimmery color, and on the other side it has a really pretty shading contouring color. So you can see here the swatches are very natural, and what I'm going to use this for is underneath my eye to create that really pretty baby doll, egg yolk sol, cutesy kind of look. So taking the shimmery, creamy side, I'm just going to kind of squidge my eyes to kind of create that shadow and just put that on the high point to create a highlight. And then going back in with the contour side, I'm just going to again squinch my eye to see where my eyes naturally make a little crease and just draw in that crease with the pencil. This is a super natural color and I really like the colors together, so you can see the difference between my two eyes here. Finally, I'm going to go back to the eyeshadow palette and take the shade Snowdrop and just put that on the inner corner of my eye. For my eyeliner, I'm going to use the True Black Eye Pen Liner. Now, I've been pretty obsessed with this because the point of this pen liner is amazing. It's very, very fine, but you can also create a more dramatic look. I love the control of this pen liner, and as you can tell, it is super, super inky, black, and opaque. So I just draw a thinner line on the inside of my eye, and as I go out, I like to extend it and make a cat eye effect. Once I'm happy with how my eyeliner looks, I'm gonna, of course, apply a little bit of mascara, and then we're gonna move on to the rest of the look. Now, of course, we're gonna use a highlighter because no Korean makeup look would be complete without a beautiful highlight. So I'm gonna use the Color Cube highlighter. This highlighter is supposed to be very comparable to Benefit's Moonbeam highlighter. And as you can see in the swatch, it's really nice because it doesn't have chunky glitter. It's more of a sheen that it adds to your skin. So again, as the rest of this makeup, it is very natural looking. So I just apply it with the doe foot applicator directly onto my skin, and then I just use my fingers to blend it out. Here I have the highlight on the right side, and I don't have any highlighter on the left side, so you can see the gorgeous effortless sheen it gives my skin. And of course, I like to highlight my nose and my Cupid's bow just because I like the way it looks. We're gonna finish off the look with, of course, a lip tint. So I'm gonna use the lip crayon in number 10 Watermelon Tint. You can see here that it doesn't actually go on green, it actually transforms into a gorgeous pinky raspberry color. I'm actually really obsessed with this lip tint at the moment, like I am with a lot of the other products, but this I have actually moved to my purse because I like it that much. You can see the gorgeous color it gives my lips, and you know me, with my dry lips, I need hydrating lip products, and that is what this is. So my lips feel comfortable throughout the day, and this leaves a really pretty tint after it wears off. Now it is time for the giveaway. So one winner will win a copy of the Little Book of Skincare. How you enter this giveaway is subscribe to Soho Glam's YouTube channel, which I will link down below. Also subscribe to my channel, The Beauty Breakdown, which is the channel you're watching if you weren't aware of that. And also follow one of my social media accounts. I will link it in the description box because that's actually where I announce the winner. So you won't actually know if you won unless you follow one of those accounts. And it's just the easiest way for me to contact you guys. And the giveaway will be open till this date. It is international, so I am paying to ship this out wherever you are in the world. And oh yeah, leave a comment down below about whatever you want to comment about, and I will pick from those entries. And of course, I do check to make sure that you guys followed all the rules. And yeah, good luck to all of you guys who enter. And as always, I hope you guys are happy and healthy. And don't forget to rate, comment, subscribe, share with your friends and family. And I'll see you guys in my next video.